Good morning, I'm Steve Thomas, and welcome back to the loft here at Ask the Salt House, where your questions send us out on our appointed rounds. Richard, you were on the road this week.
I was. I actually made water run uphill.
Amazing. Tom?
I actually helped the homeowner with a weight problem.
What a guy.
Absolutely the best. Well, we're here in West Concord, Massachusetts, with the owner of this beautiful old home, John Hill. John, this house is really close to the street. I mean, I can't believe the traffic here. How long have you lived here?
We've been here almost 10 years. It's been in my family since 1939.
Really?
And there was a story that a car pulled out of the side street, swerved, and almost hit my grandmother who was sitting in the kitchen.
Oh, boy, that must have shocked her a little bit. Well, let's take a look. I know your email said something about some windows that you had, so let's take a look inside and see what you got.
Come on in.
Well, I gotta say this, John, this house gives a whole new meaning to the line, living in the fast lane.
Sure does.
Boy, I love this granite countertop in an old house like this. This is beautiful.
Yeah, it's something my wife really wanted when we were doing the remodeling.
Well, this is great. Who's doing the remodeling?
I'm doing a lot of it myself.
This is great. I love the height of these ceilings.
They're about 9-foot ceilings.
Really spacious. Aha, this looks like one of the windows you wrote us about.
That's right. Drafty old window, we're looking to seal it up.
We got a way to show you that.
We got a few more upstairs, too.
All right, let's take a look. This looks like a nice little living room, sitting room, or?
Yep, this is our living room.
Great.
Just had all the floors redone.
And they are beautiful, too.
Thank you.
What do we got here? TV room.
Back room, and it gets rather cold in here, so we have a wood stove.
Nice light. I think you got three exterior walls. I hope you got plenty of insulation.
There's not too much under this floor, that's why it's chilly.
And here's a good weekend project, I bet, stripping this mantle.
Oh, yeah, that ended up being one of my projects this year.
Nice job. Hey, what's this front door? We thought we came in the front door.
Historically, the road out back used to be the front road.
No kidding. So we didn't live so close to the street at one time?
Not at one time.
Wow, nice little dining room. Yep,
this is where we entertain occasionally.
Great.
Why don't I show you upstairs? We have more windows up there.
You lead the way. Nice steep stairway. How many bedrooms do you have up here, John?
We have three up here.
Oh, boy. This is great. Narrow.
To the side here.
This the master?
Nope, actually the master's over here.
Oh, this is great space. Oh, I love these angles. Not a lot of height here for you, John. I got plenty of room.
No, but being 6'4", I don't have much headroom.
I love the angles. This really reminds me of a house that I grew up in.
Why don't I show you the bathroom?
Okay, you lead the way. Out the room, step down into the platform. Oh, yeah, brings back memories. Oh, boy, look at these floors, these wide floors. I love them. Did you finish these?
Yeah, we had them refinished, part of the remodeling.
Cut nails, nice job.
The small bedroom here.
Nice bedroom here. Oh, boy, look at the size of this bathroom. I never would have expected this to be this big.
Well, we used to have a stairway coming up from the kitchen.
Oh, the old back stairway, yeah.
Yeah, and we bumped the bathroom out to this spot.
Geez, you get a tub, a shower, big vanity. You got a great space up here.
That's very nice. Let me show you the office and one of the drafty windows.
Okay.
Here we go.
Yeah, you got the old standard package, weights and balances, a big hole here with a void and a lot of cold air. Let me go to the truck. I got an idea. We can fix these up. We'll work on the one downstairs.
Great.
Okay. Now, John, let me explain what you have here. These are called a double-hung window, which means that both sash are movable. And they're also hung on lines. In this case, it's a rope. Sometimes it's a chain. The rope goes up and around this pulley, and to counteract or balance the window or stop at any position that I want, it needs to have this weight. See, and that stops right there. Now, these windows also, I see, have a good locking system at the meeting rail. This lock pulls the two sash together, and it also pushes the sash down tight against the window sill, which makes a nice, tight unit. Now, these also are leaky out around here because there's no insulation in the weight pocket. The easiest way to do this is basically cut away the weights and balancing system, modify this unit ever so slightly, which means the sash, and put in a liner, a jam liner, which could be plastic or rubber, and in that unit would be a spring that would hold the window in position. Thus, we would insulate this weight pocket, and you'd have a tighter window.
Well, we like the look and feel of the old windows, so we want to stick with those.
Well, I had a feeling you'd say that. I got a way to do that.
Great.
Okay, I've just cut off a strip 2 inches wide of this polyisocyanurate foam insulation with a foil vapor barrier on it. Very high R factor on this, and it's a good product to use. I'm also going to use this urethane in a can. There's two different types here. There's a minimal expansion and a maximum expansion. This will expand three times what this does. And I want to use this first in any hard-to-get spots, like right down in here. I'm going to insulate this little bay there. And this is going to stop a chimney effect of air coming up into this wall cavity. Now, what I have to do, John, is I don't want to put too much in here because I don't want the window weight coming down and plopping into that.
How expensive is that?
This can costs about $10, but you can do a lot of windows with this. Now I'm going to do the top up above the window weight.
If you don't use it all up, what's the shelf life on that?
Well, John, a little trick is once I'm done with putting this in here, well, I leave that little bit right on the end. And I can go back to this a month later. As long as I break that off and pull it out of the tube, I can still use it. Okay, now I've insulated that. Now my 2-inch piece that I've got right here, I'm going to simply slide this into this opening. I want it to fit snug. Push it right down there. Bring it in flush with the plaster.
Now, the whole idea is it's not supposed to touch the weight or the line, correct?
That's right. We don't want to interfere with that movement of that weight.
What about moisture? Is moisture affected in any way?
No, it won't affect it at all, John. If it should get wet, which hopefully it doesn't, it'll dry out. Okay, now let's make sure this is working. Beautiful. Now we'll do the other side. All right, John, why don't you do this side? You might as well practice. You got a lot of windows to do here. Now hold the can the other way around, upside down. It won't come out. That's right. Now keep it right up against the wood on the outside of the house and bring it in. That's right. Now that's going to take a couple of hours for that to really expand, so don't put too much in there. Good. Now see if you can jam it in the top above the pulley. Hold the can, bottom of the can up. You'll get air. That's right. Fill that gap. How's that looking? Good. That's plenty. That'll grow. All right, now let's take this strip here and slide this in. Push it right in there. Now, be careful you won't break it. Put it down. That's right. Now, hold it right there. There you go. Slide it in easy. All right. Now, before you get too carried away, see if this piece fits up top. Tap it in with your fist. Careful not to break it. Beautiful. Bring it flush in with the plaster. Okay, I want it to be flush so the window casing will cover it. Beautiful. Great. Okay, one more step on the insulation part is I want to cover this seam between the foil and the plaster with foil tape.
What is that exactly?
This is a tape that is sold to the heating and cooling industry to seal all the joints and ductwork.
Is it sticky on one side? Or?
Well, it's peel away. It's basically sticky on one side, but it's two-part. I've got to peel the tape away. And I'm just going to lay it up there.
And how much does that cost?
Now you're looking at about $10 a roll, but it's key to keeping the paint on the outside of the house. It's a vapor barrier. That's good. Pull it right out. There you go. Beautiful. That's right. Beautiful. Now, one more tip. This is a piece of carpet pad. Cheap, inexpensive. Cost $8 for a 6x10 piece. It's also foam. Now what I'm going to show you a trick, simply seasonal. On a cold winter day when the wind is blowing, the air will come out of this little hole. Well, to seal that, we're going to pull the line out, put the foam under it, let it go, and that gap is sealed for the winter. The spring, you pull it out, the foam falls away, you can save it, or put some new stuff in. You're ready for business.
Great.
I don't know about you, but I feel warmer already. How do you feel?
I sure do. Hey, thanks for coming out.
My pleasure, John. It's a lot of fun.
Great.
Okay, take care.
And now, it's time for What Is It?
Gentlemen, very simple. It's red and black.
Thank you, Roger.
Oh, boy. Well, we know you're not colorblind, right?
Remember that joke with red and black?
I know exactly what it is. It's the threaded part right here.
Yeah.
You screw it onto a pole, yeah. Right? And then it adjusts for any size light bulb when you want to take a light bulb out of a hard-to-reach place.
I think you're on the right track, but I think it's a fishing implement. See, it's plastic. It won't rust. It's also adjustable. It's red so you can see it. You can see it underwater. It's for claw-hogging.
I don't think there's a big demand for that.
Yeah, well, it is. Yeah. You know. It's a specialty kind of a tool.
Yeah.
My mom had one. Actually, she's in the kitchen.
Yeah.
And for getting stuff out of a hot pot, whether it be lobster or even just spaghetti.
Like claw hogs, too. Yeah.
I've never heard you guys so far off on anything in your life. Uh-huh. Actually, it's a stand, and what you do is you take this light and screw it into the top.
And where do you put it?
Anywhere you want. See, that's the thing. You can bend it, move it, put it down low. It'd be ideal for someone like a plumber to get in hard places.
Hello. Okay.
All right.
Alrighty.
I got one right here. Blue, plastic, a lot of little pieces.
I know what that
That's
is.
That's about as close as I'm
You know, often yeah. you go into a restaurant, the table's wiggly, right? And you need, you know, you got to get a napkin or something to...
It's a wedge.
Yeah. Yeah. So if it's just a little wiggly, then you need one wedge. And, you know, if you need
nice try,
more
Steve.
Wedges, you know.
Wow. Nice
it's,
try.
It's for the traveling business.
So you carry that with you all the time?
Absolutely. Yeah. It's an essential tool.
I'm going to have to call my brother because he was using it for a whole different reason.
Really? Mm-hmm.
He's a golfer. And what you do is you carry this, and each time you have a stroke, you just deduct one. If you're over 100, you shouldn't be playing.
You have a stroke if you're over 100. But you were close, Steve. This is from a fancy restaurant. When you're done dinner and you have a few crumbs around, nice and easy,
yeah,
swept
I mean,
away.
Perfect brush.
I mean, think
yeah.
how long that would last.
Yeah, it's blue, too.
Yeah,
all
right. Points
all
right.
Yeah, nice. None of you guys were right. Hold that column, Roger. Suppose I wanted to take a piece of wood and cut to that shape. I would simply take this little piece of thing.
Little piece of thing?
Bring it in
Beautiful.
Like that. And now I just transfer this mark right here to the piece of wood.
Cool.
It's all scribed.
Oh, that's
bad,
a good
huh?
time. Very good. I'll give you a big point for that.
Good morning. Well, this is actually my second visit here. A couple weeks ago, we got an email from the homeowner saying they wanted to add a bathroom to the basement. Problem was, the main drain leaving the building was about 4 feet above grade. So I came over and I showed the homeowner exactly where to dig, including cutting the concrete. I also asked him to go to the building department and get a plumbing permit. Well, I picked up the parts, including this, a sewage ejector. Let's see how they did. Yeah, John.
Morning, Richard.
How'd you do?
Very well.
You had about 3 inches of concrete to go through.
Yes, broke right through the concrete, and underneath that was just sand.
Sand? You got lucky.
Yes.
Did you get deep enough for
yes,
this?
32 inches.
Nice. Good. Oh, hi, Cindy.
Hi. How are you doing?
Doing good. Now, you really need this bathroom, don't you?
Yes, we do. We have two boys, and it often gets tied up.
So it must be a few fights for the bathroom
yes,
in the morning.
Yes, definitely.
Now, I know you're off to work at the local school.
Yes, I am.
Do I have John for the day?
You can have him.
Great. Thanks. See
Thank you.
So how long have you guys been here, John?
6 years, Richard.
You pretty happy with the town?
Yes, very good school system for the children, good neighborhood, a lot of kids to play with.
So you're not leaving?
No, we're not.
You got a nice place for all our parts and pieces. And you've been busy down here, haven't you?
Yes, I ended on a job site. I ended up getting some free drywall, so we ended up taking down what was here and put up the drywall.
So what do you do?
Office furniture.
Okay, so you start with this room, and then it grows. You got the bathroom here. Now, you already got the drywall in here. You got hot and cold water roughed in, cold water here. Are you a plumber?
No, I'm just a handyman, but I have a few of my friends that are plumbers, and they both recommended to break through the floor and everything, and I got a little nervous, so I ended up emailing this old house.
You felt like you're a little over your head?
Yes.
Well, and so I showed you where to cut that hole. Let's see how you did over there. Here we go. Wow, you've been busy. Let me just get this out of the way. All right, so we're going to run a drain to the toilet right here with a 3-inch PVC pipe with a branch over here to the lavatory. That'll work its way right into this receiver. Now, there's a pump inside this receiver that with a little float, and when it's filled, it'll pump up here, and we'll cut this main drain right here, so there'll be a fitting here to go into. This is our whole problem. Your main drain for the house goes out so high that there's no way we could ever add a bathroom without this receiver.
Okay.
All right, so that's the drain part. That's the easy part. We still have to do the vent.
Now, why would you need a vent, and where you need a vent?
Well, if we didn't vent it, I mean, everybody knows about the drain part, but they forget about the vent side of it. If we didn't have a vent, we'd have noise from the drains, like gurgling, it wouldn't drain properly and it wouldn't be legal.
All right.
So what we'll do is we'll have a vent that'll come up here, come across the ceiling, and it'll tie into this vent, which is we're really lucky that we have a place we can tie in to make it legal.
Okay.
All right? So we're ready to get started. So we're going to start by leveling this ejector receiver. Okay, 66. See how that one fits. How are we doing, John?
Very well.
Okay, so let's just update where we are here. Here's our vent that's got to continue back over to the vent line. We've got all this dry fit. Here's our for our trap in the lavatory. 2-inch branch coming here. There's our 3-inch to our toilet. Now we just got to mark it all, and when we're sure, we'll glue it up.
Richard, why do you have to mark out all these pieces?
Well, it's really a safety. We've got to take apart all these fittings, clean them, and then glue them simultaneously.
Okay.
Now, I don't have that much open time with the glue, and if it freezes in the wrong position, then I may have to discard this whole piece. So it's a safety.
Oh, okay.
All right, grab me that glue and cleaner. Okay.
Primer and cleaner.
Yeah. Good, primer first. All right, I want you to hold this part right there.
Now, what does this stuff do?
Well, it cleans the plastic, obviously, and also softens the material to make a really good bond. Now, hold on to that. Okay, tip it down towards me so it runs out. Okay, now we're ready to glue this joint. Okay, so still hold it. I'm going to grab you first.
Now, you have to do both sides?
Keep tipping it down towards me. Well, I'm gonna, right now, I can do just one side at a time. And we hold it for a three count. Okay, so now we're going to do this side. So hold that pipe up. Same drill. Okay, I got the newspaper in there to keep the sand from getting into the joint.
That's nice.
Okay, so glue, hold on. And when I get this glued, you got to push in towards me. Okay, come on in. Keep coming, come on. Hold from that side. Keep coming, come on. Come on, go. Come on, lift. Out of the way. There you go. Good job. That's great. Nice job on that. Now, this is the important one. I have to line up those marks, and I got about 2 seconds to do it. So let's try that. Inbound. Right there is actually where I want it. All right, that's perfect. Now we'll continue with the rest of the joints. All right, now it's your turn, Joan. Just prime that. And this side. Okay, good. Now glue. Inside, yep. Outside. Get those marks to push in. Push in tight, and then make those marks line up and hold it.
So, Richard, how did I do?
Good, but just hold it. Hold it. Good. Let's go on and do some more. All right, now I want to do this closet bend. You ready to go in there, John?
Yes, I am.
And I'm going to prime and glue one side. And when I push, I need you to hold back against me.
Okay.
Right, this is clean. Okay. Coming at you now. Okay, and I got marks on the floor to establish the right distance off the wall. Good. Right. Okay, we'll clean that up with an emery cloth, and we'll put those clamps on. All right, here's what we're dealing with here. This is the transition from the copper to our plastic vent. So there's a stainless steel clamps, neoprene gaskets. We'll put that up in and tighten it up with this torque wrench. It's a bit of a wiggle.
Is this all legal and is it okay by the billing department?
Absolutely. This is a fitting made for this transition between different materials. And it's a bit of a tight fit. But that's what you want. There we go.
What type of wrench is that? I've never seen one of those before.
It's actually called a torque wrench. And what it is, it's a socket that's designed so it won't let me over-tighten it. So as I get close, see how it releases? So I can't wreck the clamp.
That's a good little tool.
All right, now for the pump. John, just guide that pipe with me. I'm going to set this down into the pit.
All right.
Okay. What about there? Now there's a cover. That one, perfect. Got to remember to put this on first. That drops down over the top. We'll fish that wire through afterwards. Now there's a discharge check valve. You got that?
Right here.
Okay. So this check valve is designed so that when the pump pushes water up, it'll only go into the drain, and it won't go back down again. And no water from the rest of the house can go down this way. So it's a very important part. I just make this up. And then we're going to tighten that up with the same torque wrench, and we're making progress.
Absolutely. What exactly does this pipe do?
Well, this is the vent for the receiver. You know, when that pump comes on, it pulls all that water and pushes up into the drain. It creates a vacuum. So we have to relieve that with the vent. So the vent runs up here, ties into the vent that comes from the new bathroom, and it ties into the vent that goes up through the roof.
Oh, okay.
Hey, save me a little sand for in here.
No problem, Richard. Now, Richard, what's all that paper for?
Well, this last piece has not been glued yet. So when you pour the concrete in here, I don't want this pipe trapped so I can't take it out afterwards. Because once this is tiled, this flange wants to go in and you want to cut that pipe at just the right height. All right, so this is ready for concrete now. Now, we are ready for a test. Do you have a garden hose with a...
Yes, I do. Good. I'll get it right now.
Good.
Did it turn on yet, Richard?
No, there's a float that's almost to the top. It's about to come on. You'll hear it, too. I wouldn't normally peek at this thing like this. Here it comes. There she goes. Ta-da!
That's awesome. Thank you very much. The Johnstones now have a second bathroom. Thank you, Richard.
All right.
Great stuff, fellas. But I had a question, Richard. Is there any odor associated with that unit? After all, it is in the laundry room.
None at all. It is a gasket at the top, and we bolted it right down tight.
All right. Terrific. So until next time, I'm Steve Thomas.
I'm Tom Silva.
I'm Richard Thurman.
For Ask This Old House.
And then we hit the camera.
That's right. Email your questions to our online address, asktoh@pbs.org, or write to us, care of This Old House Magazine, 1185 Avenue of the Americas, New York, New York, 10036. And thanks.